Okay. Well, without going into too much depth about all these cards, this is amazing. Everybody knows it. I don't think there's any debate. Okay. I like Burden of Guilt. I also like God's Curse. Cryptite's fine. Wolf is pretty good. But card for card, I like Death's Crest more, even though I'm almost certainly white, or trying to go that way, I mean. Oh, it's a tough call, though. Burden of Guilt basically does the same thing that Death's Crest does. Yeah, I don't know. This just gets the job done. That life gain is relevant too. I'm not sure about that pick now. Oh, nice. Lots of good stuff. You know, Briar Pack is ridiculous. Tower Geist is ridiculous too. It's basically between these two. I have to say, I don't know. I really don't know. It's really tough. The Wolf is amazing. So is that Token Maker spell there that I just passed away on. But can't complain with removal. Yeah, this Wolf is better than this or the Scab, but better synergy with these three colors, and you know, basically have a blue card versus not having any green and not wanting to play green white, I don't think, or green black even. Not that they're bad at all, but I like to make use of the Lingering Soul Splashback even if possible. Getting greedy. Very solid card. Faith Shield. glad to see that. Those cards are good. I don't know, I could easily take that blue one or something, but this is just so good I couldn't morally pass that. Maybe I'll be green yet. Works. I don't love this thing, but it's totally obviously best in this build with little creatures and humans. And it enables Mormon, of course. Possibly argue the Blazing Torch, but certainly early enough that Brimstone Ball is gonna make the deck, probably. Maybe not, but there's a good chance. Burial Rites or Vampire. Rites is obviously really good, but I like this card a lot. And in this kind of archetype, Imperial Rites isn't the best. Even though I'm playing the colors, of course, it makes it really appealing, obviously, but it's a little bit slow and not ideal in this kind of deck. Assuming it goes this way. More of the same. I mean, if you're vampires or something, you could pick that 4-3 guy, whatever, but this thing's pretty solid, and obviously it goes with the theme still. Captain Corpse is fine, but I might have that curve, farther curve covered, and want a little bit more removal. Smite the Monstrous is pretty good. It's like just short of a Death's Crest. I would say a decent bit short, but still quite good. Be early enough to take this. But this is fine. I'll keep it simple. Taking that white card. And that red curse goes really late. I think there's archetypes for it. Namely, super aggressive. I think that's the finisher. Or, obviously, you happen to come across a curse type deck. A black one that deals to the number of. I'm not sure if I've done it yet, but both of these are good. The box is good. I'd say the Mausoleum cards. Let's pick. Even though it's daggers. Quite good, especially my deck. I mean, this guy's solid. You always get the two flyers, but it's like a little slow, not threatening, just kind of. I don't know, I was totally going to take this, but change my mind. Wouldn't mind popping the guys, helping them. Okay, the best card here is clearly the Murder of Crows. But I kind of want to, oh my goodness, since I just stick to black-white, but could open my mind with this Silent Departure. I mean, of heroism is pretty good, but I'm hoping to get it back, but I won't. If I am playing blue, the double blue, it's not even really possible. No, I can obviously pick this, it's like, fine. I don't know. Some good stuff. I like, this thing's so good. Bonds of Night. What's the pick? Beautiful. Tribute to Hunger is amazing. You can't go wrong playing it. Obviously, I remember some good stuff. Fester High. This wave's good. This thing's fine, but. Anyways, Midnight Haunting, though. Lots of little dudes. I should take it just because it's the foil. But really, the pick. I could even use this. I was gonna say the hate draft on these or something, but fights are prey upon. It's good. Ah. The ringer's alright though. Hate to pass this. It's an elite prey upon. I should have known I wasn't going to get away with blue. Even with involving wilds, I doubt I'll be playing those two. Maybe if I have to, I don't have that many cards. But, anyways. We'll see if it's worth just playing those two. You don't ask me why I wanted to. Be draft. Or even play it possibly against the right deck, I don't know. Or can you imagine? I mean, even just with like there, right? You obviously see that kind of beautiful synergy works. Simple things. Or that guy with the demon male hauberk or whatever. Stuff like that. Let's see here. I think we'll start counting now. I should have probably got playables. Was a pick the uncommon versus the card you know here. Not gonna side it. It's funny because when I picked the first one, I was like, oh, you never know, I might side that in again. But the odds of siding two versus the odds of getting an automatic uncommon. I've been thinking this card's bad for some reason, but in all humans, or if you have mostly humans, it doesn't seem terrible. It's supposed to. That's funny, I've just been poo-pooing it. Don't have many creatures. Can easily play night terrors, but help arm what few creatures I do. looks like a nice church or something. I'm such a fan of architecture. Buildings, space. Pause. Must be something deep in our DNA that causes lots of people to see beauty in structured physical living, you know, from however many years of living in caves wanting to find the best house. This is why I don't pick this card early. Just an example. I mean, clearly one example of why it's kind of slow or whatever doesn't mean anything, but it's just, like I said, it's a certain kind of card. Just a little bit slow. Just like I am. I probably should have played equipped last turn, maybe. Anyways. Maybe stupid, I don't know. that share beats than on land. I like how with this guy, you don't really have to choose whether he attacks or not. With difficulty. I was gonna play this, but kind of cool if I could actually just play them both when I have 5 life, maybe. Optimistically speaking, of course, I'll probably have to play one next turn. But I could play this guy, of course, possibly even this, but I don't want to do that. Although it would be kind of cool. Pump them up next turn. I just take 5, 6, 7, and then play the tokens, then that would get bigger. It wouldn't be that bad. I totally changed my mind. I'm like, man, maybe that's the way to go. Because with this, I'd only want to block this, so I'm only preventing 2 damage by playing the Bell Ringer versus the Mob. But this way, I get more triggers out of it next turn, right? I don't know. And I'm at 5, so I get bunch of them. Yay. What a douche. Now I feel like just saying good game, you know what I mean? You bastard. That's me being nice. Let's do some math here for 5. Oh yeah, okay. Features I control, time of turn. Oh, let's do that. Press F6. Sorry, heck, I got me a little bit around that one. Well, I mean, it's just enjoyable to beat people who are actually assholes. Well, I can't risk that. I can't believe I didn't. I was just. Yeah. That was the worst ever. deck looks really good. See if I got any rares. None. Wow. I was sort of saying that half jokingly, assuming I'd get one or so. With these two guys, I'm starting to realize, well, and other stuff, but just over time, how important that Shimmering Grotto is, and this even is really nice, of course, because splashing other colors is really cool in this format. Like, I can honestly even play those two. Play that splash or flashback. Cutting creatures is not good. I always get the enchantment. It's sort of another reason to keep that. I sort of want to do it. I don't know. It's just like, I don't know. Why not? Something like that. That just goes to show how, you know, even one little change in your deck, you know. See that in reality. It's like, you know, when I used to, well, I still do, bad habit, I guess, but I don't plan on talking in the chat rooms anymore about stuff or whatever. I mean, who knows? I might again, but I don't plan on, anyways, people are always, whatever, saying yada yada, Shuffler sucks, whatever, broken, right? Classic, that's it. And sometimes I say, well, honestly, and I know they're not even listening, whatever, and it's kind of irrelevant to even say it, but, you know, when I play 9 of a certain land and 8 of another, you're more than likely to see the 9. You get 2 of those 9 land, you know, and, like, in your opening hand, you see 2 of those versus 1 of the other. Snap. I should have just killed this. Food saver. piece. Holy crap. I don't think I can risk. I still want to save this. But I don't think I can risk another form of, you know, creature removal or whatever. Losing. Kind of have to kill this now, I suppose. Seems safest. Okay, this is game three. That takes care of that. I should do this. You can send me back and do yesterday. Certainly. And I think I'm going to lose this game. Oh, nice. That's good, too. instant I can't think of. I've said it before, but I'll say it again. Always play first. That's the only thing I know for sure. I suppose I'm not worried about taking another 3 damage for some reason. I want to get my own stuff going. See all this stuff, maybe. The same point I really wanted to. Like I said, get stuff going, or I don't really know. Equip next turn. Flashback or something, even. Or rebuke it. Bonds of Faith, flashback, whatever. You have 2 more guys that are coming. I guess I'll save all those dummy spells. I don't even know if I want to block. He's not sure if no start time and other things, whatever those three cards are. I assume it's not removal, or else he'd probably just do that. Maybe he's got multiple pieces of removal, but apparently he can't kill this yet, so that's a good thing. Take it. Oh snap. Good thing I got lucky. I play that just in case he kills something, and then I can have my blockers already just to save time. Whatever. It's fast and sloppy. That's how I play. I should try that red version now. I don't know. Might be right to do. Might not. It's probably just fancy for no reason. And you're probably gonna play into the mountain and a spectral rider or something like that. Or a swamp, then a mountain. You'll need your death's caress. That does happen. Of course, I mean, get more power out of three colors, but it's very good to be picky about your mana base. Whether I do it right or not, but I'm just saying for your extra colors and stuff, you know, generally speaking, Sealed's a little bit more liberal with deck building with colors and stuff, but I don't know. You have to assume you're going to just have two lands in your open hand, you know, of any type. Like, I know that doesn't make sense, but just to be careful, of course. Like this, for example, right? If that was a plains, I could keep this. But, as it is now, since I got fancy, I have to choose whether I want to keep this or not. Maybe risky, I don't know. Yep. Okay. If I could do that differently, I'm sure. Well, that was a disaster. Disaster. Such a nice backup. I suppose I can be aggressive here. Should I kill it? No. I don't know why that wasn't good, but I didn't really even consider it was the problem. Suppose I could attack with both and then pop someone that gets blocked. Which would be this one. I don't even know if this is good. I guess this guy. His hand is like, he's probably got double black spells or something. Well, that was an ideal. Just don't play anything. It certainly helps. Which is X. Does it say? Can't even see. X is 4, maybe? Must be. Works. Well, I'll see you guys tomorrow or whatever.